stages of transition, which I do believe not only are we in on a personal or individual basis, but I think those stages are changing on a global basis as far as the Church of Jesus Christ. And so Wednesday afternoon, we went out to lunch with the pastor and his wife there in North LA. And while we were over lunch, I just kind of ventured the idea without a lot of details of the transition of graces for the Church of Jesus on a global scale, global level. That COVID has been a tool the enemy caused, but God has certainly desired to use to change the very MO, the mode of operation of Jesus's church in the earth. It's required us, it's of necessity, it's made us have to reprocess much of how we've done business with God and how we've done business with each other. And that I went on to say that we probably don't want to continue in the same way. We want to be looking for MO of the change. What does the new MO look like? What is that like? I says, and actually, I can't say that I know a whole lot about what the new MO is. All I believe it requires of us is, the one mandatory thing it requires is that we hear his voice and hear it well, and that we're committed to moving by his voice only, which we've talked about a number of times today. Jesus only did what his Father said, right? And so I was just presenting that idea. Well, anyway, that night is the night that we had this amazing experience. And because at last minute, there hadn't been a translator designated, he ended up translating, and he does a great job, and he and I are good friends. So he was right there front and center with this whole thing. In fact, because he had to translate, he had to actually give the word, you might say. I just kind of had to smile how the Lord put that one together. It was just a really cool thing. But anyway, the whole order of the meeting had very, very little to do with hardly anything that we do in most public meetings. Worship was not really even led. It was just kind of there, and we just kind of all began to marinate. Just two little songs. They didn't have any real strong leadership. They were just there, and it was really wonderful. And then I just opened up John 10:9. And from there on out, it was so organic and so real and so life-giving. And so, what's the word I'm fishing for here? Establishing the validity of a fresh new way. And so, and we all got to be a part of it, touch it, feel it, like John in First Epistle of John. I tell you the things we saw and touched. So.